Hey, John Painter with Blue Water Yacht Sales, Beaufort, North Carolina. I am standing here on a listing of mine. It's a 2006 Farmont 70 Expedition Yacht. Built by Farmont Yachts of Germany as a 2006 model. It's a true expedition yacht. In fact, it came over here on its own bottom several years ago by the original owner. It's built as a Class A yacht, meaning it's certified for force 8 winds on the Beaufort scale, which is 40 knots and above, seas exceeding 14 feet. Just wanted to do a walkthrough of the boat and just kind of introduce you to it. Standing on the bow, you've got a hydraulic anchoring system, twin anchors, again, yacht quality, a 14,000 pound davit with an extendable boom, Zodiac rigid bottom, tender, 40 horsepower Honda, large storage boxes forward here, large cleats. Stepping up onto the bridge, Portuguese bridge. You have docking stations, port and starboard, with thruster controls for your bow and stern thrusters. So again, to have the ability to step out of the pilot house and be able to see the dock when you're docking. All right, moving aft around the starboard side, pilot house, access door to the pilot house. Of course, all the doors are watertight doors, true expedition yacht. Teak flooring, point out that it is glued down. You don't have drilled into the decks, which is very nice. Very nice wide side decks, easy access around the boat. That's entrance into the main cabin area. One of the engine room access doors, standing on the aft of the Farmont. You've got a very nice seating area here. Beautiful teak table, same as up top on that deck. Little sitting area here, some storage. Life rafts just haven't been put in place, but they've been recertified. There's 2 8-man rafts there that are current. Okay, standing on the upper decks of the Farmont, very open areas on the upper decks, observation areas. Teak table here for entertaining. Canvas top. Stepping on up top. Again, this is all just open deck space, observation areas. A lot of room for entertaining. Of course, you're masked with all your electronics, satellite, radar communications, cameras. Looking down on the foredeck. Standing in the pilot house, pretty much a full Simrad electronic suite, everything you expect in an expedition yacht. Redundant systems, redundant radars, controls. Like I said, everything you'd expect in an expedition yacht. It's a very large pilot house, doors on each side. Of course, again, watertight doors. Sitting area here. Back here is kind of a captain's day bed. That was the door that went outside to the upper decks. Standing in the salon area, you've got nice big sofas, a lot of storage. There's a pop-up TV in this area forward. Would like to mention some of the recent upgrades. The entire headliner in the boat has been done. It's got new carpet in it. All right, moving forward in the boat, it's kind of a mid-level galley. You step down 3 steps. Very nice dinette area to starboard. Moving over into the galley, kind of what you would expect, commercial grade appliances, Siemens from the refrigerator to the stove, dishwasher, trash compactor. Okay, now we're going to step forward in the boat down into the living quarters. Yeah, stepping forward immediately on the right is a dayhead. I'm standing in a master stateroom, which is midship on the port side. It's a king size bed, kind of side two. A lot of storage. The woodwork in this boat is outstanding. Full size TV, there is a hidden gun safe behind this door. Stepping into the head. Stall shower in the corner. Just a very, again, it's the master suite, so the lavatory is going to be very large. Moving forward, starboard side, midship, is a single berth stateroom. It kind of doubles as an office also. There's a desk area. I am all the way forward now in the boat in what we would consider the VIP, an island queen, separate head, again, a lot of storage. I'm actually standing up back to the bed, so it's not that tall in here. But yes, this would be considered the VIP. Standing on the transom, very nice transom area. Here's one of the accesses to the engine room, and of course it's a watertight door. You can't see it, but here is a passerelle that hydraulically comes out, you know, extends, so it'll reach the dock for boarding. I'm standing in the lazarette area where you've got some systems. You've got a converter for the shore power, some freshwater systems, some hydraulic systems. Again, it's an expedition yacht, so the systems are going to be pretty extensive. Moving forward from the lazarette, I'm standing in a landing area. There's also an engine room access door starboard side on the deck, which that's what's coming down right here. Immediately here are the crew's quarters. It's over and under crisscross bunks. They have their own shower, they have their own head, TV, stereo, DVD player. Okay, moving forward into the engine room in the landing here across from the crew's quarters, you've got washer and dryer, Bosch, of course, commercial grade stuff. And then, of course, a watertight door leading into the engine room. All right, standing in the engine room. This is where you really realize that this is a true expedition yacht. Expansive engine room, stand up, of course. You've got twin Cummins QSM11s detuned to 450 horsepower. They're less than 2,300 original hours. Of course, you've got twin generators, hydraulic takeoffs on the engines to run all the hydraulic systems. Moving forward, you got a workbench area. And again, just it's an expedition yacht. You'll realize that there's a lot of redundant systems. Being able to, if you lose one pump, you can turn valves to operate another pump. An interesting point, the boat is stabilized. It's got NIAID stabilizers. If you look on the port and starboard side forward engine room, you have sea chests. Well, those house the stabilizer fins. So if in some catastrophic situation, if you were to shear one off and the shaft fall out, you're still dry because they're encapsulated in a sea chest. Boat carries 5,200 gallons of fuel to make those open ocean crossings. Again, just commercial grade equipment everywhere you look. Water maker over here in this corner. Chiller system for your refrigerators. Now we're standing on the ground here on the yard. Let's take a quick walk around the boat. Standing at the bow, we've got twin anchors on a hydraulic windlass system. We've got a bow thruster, a bulbous bow for efficiency, a true expedition yacht. The yacht is stabilized with NIAID stabilizers. You've got a stern thruster incorporated into the keel. Another notable feature is you've got prop pockets, which raises the props, and as you can see, they're above the keel. So you've got some shallow water protection there. Again, this is John Painter with Blue Water Yacht Sales in Beaufort, North Carolina. I appreciate you taking a look. For more information, you can check it out on our website. Also, the boat's easy to see. It's here on the Jarrett Bay Boatyard in Beaufort, North Carolina. Easy fly-in access to New Bern, North Carolina, about 30 minutes away. So very easy to see.